Yet another social category was that of the free peasants who owned their own land. In Valachia they were called moșneni, an ancient word that comes from the pre-Roman layer in our language related to moș, which is Romanian for old man. In Moldavia, the same people were called răzeși, the origins of which are still uncertain. First, it was believed it came from the Hungarian răzes, but that word has quite a different meaning, and some linguists doubt it would have resulted in răzeși in Romanian. Some found a Polish origin for it, others a Turkish one, others one in Latin, from the root radius, in Romanian meaning rază. I wonder though, since it denominates an archaic layer of rural society, whether it too could possibly have an ancient local root like the word moșnean. The matter is yet to be resolved. The răzeși and moșneni were free men, owners of small farms worked by an extended family that allotted the land to its members each year. This type of organization was unique to the Romanians, different from the Serbian zadruga or other structures found in Slavic people. Some of the oldest documents referring to these people reveal that the first known ancestor of a community had in fact held the rank of the boyar. In time, however, their status had reverted to that of the free landholders. As the tribute to the Ottoman Turks grew over time, so did the tax burden on the peasant masses, whose condition worsened ever further. During the 16th and 17th century, many were forced to sell their lands to a boyar, thus ending up on the same level as the serfs.